everyone, welcome to another Color Wednesday. Today I'm using a stencil from Claudine Helmuth. This is the Wallflower Stencil, and I'm going to be using some Copic markers on it. I did a little test run, so that's the color you're seeing on the stencil. I've cut out a piece of 4.25 by 5.5 inch tall Basil marshmallow cardstock. So it's just the same size as the front of a card. I'll eventually cut it down just a little bit, but at this point it was the size of a standard card. And I'm using some washi tape to tape down both the cardstock and the stencil, because I don't want the cardstock moving around at all, and I don't want the stencil moving around either. Using the Copic airbrush system. You guys saw this last Friday. It's basically this little air can and then this nozzle that twists on top, and then you can place a marker in. Now, in my video last Friday, I used the brush tip, and I had no idea you were supposed to use the chisel tip, and apparently you are. The brush tip I was able to use. It didn't cause any problems, but I did find that the ink came out a little bit better when you use the chisel tip. So that's what I'm using today. And I'm just using short bursts to do some horizontal spraying across the stencil pattern. I kind of want a little bit of a fading of colors. So I'm starting with yellow, and then I moved on to like a reddish pink, and I did a few sprays of that. And then I moved on to a purple color. So I'm just spraying that down. I really love this purple. I liked how intense it was. And then I moved on to the very last color, which was a blue. Just added some blue down there at the bottom. And just spraying all along, trying to get a really good blending of colors. And then I took off the stencil, and you'll see what it looks like underneath. It's like Christmas morning, as Julie Ippersall says, when you take a mask off. So there's my piece that's gonna be the main part of the card. As far as the card base goes, I'm using some Basil licorice cardstock, and I just scored that at 5.5, so it's a top fold card. And I cut down my airbrushed piece just a tiny bit. I just took 1/4 inch off each side, and then I'm gluing that down to my card base. That's because I just wanted a little bit of a black border around the edge. I think when you have a lot of white and really bright colors, bringing in a little bit of black is awesome. It just makes all the colors pop. So I'm using the Tilted Banners dies from Simon Says Stamp, and I'm going to cut both of these banners, although I really only need one, but I have that whole big box of just die cuts that are ready to go, and I thought I'd just add that other one in there. So these folded banners have square lines on them, but when you use a thicker piece of cardstock, sometimes it cracks. So I like to take a stylus and just go over those score lines a little bit, really press in to make sure that they fold a little bit easier. Before I start folding, I'm using the Tilted Banner Saying stamp set. It's the stamp set that's made to match the die set. Just stamp the Hope Your Day is Awesome in Versamark ink. And I'm using some white embossing powder on that banner. The color's really gonna pop with that white right on top. Heat set that embossing powder until it melted. And then I went to folding the banner. So I just folded down the top and then fold up the outer edge. And then you have a little fold there, and it creates a folded banner. So it's three-dimensional. I cut a foam square in half, cut a foam square in half and put that in the center of the banner. And then I used my stamp runner, which if you just press down on that pink handle part, it'll just give like one little square of adhesive. So I did that on each end of the banner. And then I placed that on the bottom section of the card just to break up that white space a little bit. And the last thing I did was I went around with a black marker, really thin marker, just to add some stitching lines. And that finishes the card. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I will catch you guys next time. Thanks for watching.